welcome to St. Isidore's. Let's join together in singing our opening song, number 646, in the music issue, Save Us, O Lord, number 646.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather to celebrate the Eucharist today, we pause. We ask Jesus to forgive us our sins.
Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, for freedom Christ set us free. So stand firm and do not submit again to the yoke of slavery. It is I, Paul, who am telling you that if you have yourselves circumcised, Christ will be of no benefit to you. Once again, I declare to every man who has himself circumcised that he is bound to observe the entire law. You are separated from Christ, you who are trying to be justified by law. You have fallen from grace. For through the Spirit, by faith, we await the hope of righteousness. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision nor uncircumcision counts for anything, but only faith working through love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm response, let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord, your salvation according to your promise. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord. Take not the word of truth from my mouth, for in your ordinances is my hope. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord. And I will keep your law continually, forever and ever. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord. And I will walk at liberty because I seek your precepts. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord. And I will delight in your commands, which I love. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord. And I will lift up my hands to your commands and meditate on your statutes. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After Jesus had spoken, a Pharisee invited him to dine at his home. He entered and reclined at table. The Pharisee was amazed to see that he did not observe the prescribed washing before the meal. The Lord said to him, O you Pharisee, although you cleanse the outside of the cup and the dish, inside you are filled with plunder and evil. You fools, did not the maker of the outside also make the inside? But as to what is within, give alms, and behold, everything will be clean for you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Many, many years ago, when I was an assistant in Omaha, I went to a home one time to get a deposition for a marriage case I was working on. And I walked up on the porch and I rang the doorbell. A lot of racket going on inside. And then out of the corner of my eye, I saw somebody pushing aside the drape a little bit and peeking out. And then I heard, oh my God, it's the priest. Clean up this mess. And I had to wait out there for about 3 minutes, and the lady came to the door. Oh, Father, it's so good to see you. They were very happy to see me. I just stayed for a minute, but it was a very humorous thing, and today's first, the Gospel reminded me of that. I have strange memories sometimes when I read the Gospels and reflect upon them. But just imagine if you invited your pastor for a dinner. Not that that ever happens. Once in a great while it does. But if you did invite your pastor to dinner, you want to put on a good front, so you tidy up the house, so you cook a good meal, a gourmet dinner. And supposing then you sat down with the pastor and said, Father, would you lead us in prayer? And he would say to you, oh, don't bother with that nonsense. You people, you fools, you go through the words, you pray the words, but you're not even thinking about it. You just rattle them off. Can you imagine how the rest of the conversation would go that evening? And probably be the last time you'd ever invite a priest to dinner. And yet when you read the Gospel, sometimes it's kind of what Jesus did. And you have to kind of wonder exactly. Of course, we don't know if this is exactly what Jesus did or this is Matthew's reflection on it years later or something like that, trying to make a point. But the more I reflect upon the Gospels and some of the things that Jesus did, the more compassion I have for the Jewish people of that time and the Pharisees, who have often gotten a bum rap as being hypocritical people. I think they were very sincere in their worship in many ways, especially the Pharisees. They really tried to follow the kosher laws, and that was not easy because those 614 or 13 precepts covered every single action that you ever did in your house. If you served meat in a platter today, tomorrow you had to use a different platter to serve cheese. all these regulations, and it was almost impossible for anybody to follow them all. And yet I think they did that sincerely. And then Jesus comes along. He's an outsider. He's from Galilee. As one of the apostles himself said, can anything good come out of Galilee? He's not educated. He's not a part of the ordinary group in Jerusalem, the upper class, the people who are respectable and you look up to. And he's upsetting everything we believe in. That's bad enough. And then most importantly, he starts talking and acting like he has a special relationship with God, that he's the Son of God, that you can address God as Abba Father. I mean, no good, respectable Jew at that time would ever even thought of addressing God as Abba Father. That's too intimate a term. It's kind of like daddy, our relationship with the child. And God is so far above us. And then here's this guy from Galilee, an ordinary carpenter, not educated as we are, and he's making himself like God. It's no wonder they were upset with him. No wonder they wanted to get rid of him. And it's all the more reason why I believe when Jesus prayed from the cross, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He truly meant that prayer because they truly did not know what they were doing. But the incredible thing is that God the Son did become man and live among us. And he did that, as we'll see in the closing prayer at Mass today, he did that so that one day you and I may share in God's divine nature. That's incredible to think about. God wants us to become part of him. Often we say these prayers and they just go over us because we don't have the moment to reflect upon that. But think about that. God the Son became man. He descended and came down to become an ordinary, lowly human being so that one day we can share in the very divine life of God himself. It truly is incredible. As I reflect in these Gospels, I guess the one thing that we can all call to mind is just to make sure that we just don't go through the motions when we say our prayers or whatever we do, just to do it because that's what we do. We say our prayers to get them done for the day. But no, we really have to slow down and reflect upon what we're doing and making sure that our heart is really in what we're doing. When we say our prayers before and after meals, we really reflect on how wonderful it is that we live in a country where we never have to go hungry, where we have enough food to be grateful to God, etc. So today as we celebrate the Eucharist, reflect upon that, think about that, and all of us always have to continually remind ourselves what it is that we are doing when we pray, when we go about doing these things, and make sure that they come from the heart and we're truly giving honor and glory and praise to God. So with that in mind, let us pray. O God, our Heavenly Father, you sent your Son to be our Savior, and he willingly died on the cross for us. Help us to be faithful in our worship of him and follow him faithfully, so that one day, through your great love and mercy, we can share in your very divine life. Grant us this, Lord, in the favors we ask in Jesus' name.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for Archbishop Lucas, Bishop Conley, and Bishop Hanifel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those who serve us in public office, our president, members of the House and Senate, that they, with the local legislators, especially in a time of crisis, will strive to work together for what is best for our country. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all parents and teachers, that they may always strive to reflect the love of Jesus to the children, each and every day, by word and example. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our departed loved ones, that they may know the joys of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace throughout our country, and especially in our inner cities, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For more vocations to the priesthood and religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the farmers, that they be kept safe from all accidents during the harvest season, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own unspoken needs and intentions, let us pause and pray in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We offer this Mass this morning for the living and deceased of the Bernard and Mary Doman family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, our Father in heaven, please grant us these and all our needs, for which we pray to you today in Jesus' name, for he is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer with humble and contrite hearts. Wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashion for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might be the means of our salvation, through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adore your majesty and rejoice in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. And therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. And therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by his death, you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Joseph, Saint Isidore, and with all your saints, on whose constant intercession we rely on your failing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you summon before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to either passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity and accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Peace, Kelly.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Please join me in making a spiritual communion. By Jesus, I believe you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you have fed us with the nourishment that comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers in his divine nature through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and grant you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go forth glorifying the Lord by your life.
Let's join together in singing number 563. Lift up your hearts, number 563.
Today's Morning Mass is brought to you in part by these sponsors.